I'm meteorologist Chris Holcomb from the 11 Alive Storm Trackers. We continue to track this next winter weather system that's moving our way, impacting us during the day on Tuesday. The latest development that we have for you this afternoon is that the National Weather Service has now upgraded the winter storm watch to a winter storm warning over far north Georgia, and then a winter weather advisory here for the metro Atlanta area. Here's how this divides up. You can see these counties up in north Georgia that are in the white color here. It comes down to the Rome area, on up into parts of Pickens County, and on also into areas of Fannin County, Gilmer County, Dawson County, Gordon County as well. Also over into Habersham County and White County. That line up to the north, all of those counties you see in white, that's where we have a winter storm warning. 1 to 3 inches of snow possible there. Not a guarantee, just up to 3 inches possible. And then we're watching for black ice to develop once those temperatures go below freezing. The counties in purple here that you see that move down toward Hall County, Gwinnett County, DeKalb County, also into Clayton County, Fayette County, down into the Coweta County area and Heard County, all of those counties to the north of that in purple is where we have a winter weather advisory in effect. Up to 1 inch of snow possible there, but our main concern is that whatever moisture is still on the ground when this really cold air moves in, we could see some black ice developing, and I think that would be more likely after sunset here as we go into Tuesday. Here's a look at the snow accumulation forecast. I want you to watch here. As we go through the early morning hours tomorrow, this is going to change over to snow around 3 or 4 in the morning and then move through the metro Atlanta area mid-morning and then fall apart before it ever gets to Athens. And this light blue color indicating snow of less than 1 inch. And then these darker blues that you see here over parts of north Georgia, even over on the west side, is where we could see 1 to 3 inches of snow that could come down here in our area. Here's a look at all of our models on top of each other here. Right now, the blue color, which is the NAM, that is showing the most snow for metro Atlanta, up to 1.5 inches, and then everybody else is less than 1 inch, and I really think that that would be less than 1 inch. That's for the RPM Euro and also the GFS, so that's kind of what we're watching here, going with less than 1 inch expected. So here's the timeline. Tonight we're going to be fine. We're just going to see clouds building in, but no moisture moving in tonight. It's going to be starting tomorrow morning. This is at 6 o'clock. You can see still dry in Atlanta. Southerly flow, we're going to have our warmest temperatures of the day in the morning hours. Here comes the rain, and then quickly changing over to snow in northwest Georgia. This is at 6 o'clock. Here we are at 8 o'clock. Rain on the west side of the metro area. There's the snow in northwest Georgia. That starts closing in by 9:30. Rain in Atlanta. There's that rain snow line going through Carrollton, through Cobb County, also on up to the north toward Gilmer and Union County as well. Then changing over to snow here in the metro Atlanta area, mid-morning to late morning. And then by lunchtime, we really think that's going to start falling apart. And it's just all rain as it goes over on the east side. I'm not even really concerned about any big time snow chances there. And then all the moisture clears out. But that's not all we're talking about, folks. After sunset on Tuesday, we're going to be watching those temperatures fall very rapidly here. This is the freezing line, okay? See that blue line right there? So with those temperatures, those colder temperatures coming in, we could see ice developing, black ice developing first in far north Georgia, northwest Georgia, and then whatever does not dry up that is on the ground, that's where we could see that black ice developing, and I think those will be the main threats for Tuesday night and into Wednesday morning. All right, stay with us here from the 11 Alive Storm Trackers. We'll keep watching this system as it's developing, moving toward us, and bring you any new changes to any advisories or warnings, and also any new model updates to you too.